Question number 14 deals with what? Orbital speed. Time period. Energy of a satellite moving around a planet. Say planet Earth, its mass is m, the radius of the planet is r. A satellite moves around the planet, mass of the satellite is small m, radius of the orbit in which it moves is r. We have to find out what? Five parameters. First part, A part, yes? Orbital speed. Notes band kar do. Two pages required. Draw the diagram. Draw a diagram. And find the speed of the satellite moving around the planet, say Earth. Concept, yes, anyone? First step, concept, yes. Gravitational force provides, gravitational force provides necessary centripetal force. So it is G M M by R square, small r. R is the distance between the center of the two masses, is equal to what? M V square by R. M M cancel. R power 1, R power 2. When you solve, you find V orbital is equal to what? Gm by r under root. This is one. For a particle near surface of Earth, near surface of Earth, suppose a satellite moves near surface of Earth, its orbital speed will come out to be what? Gm by r. Yes, again, you can multiply and divide it by r. What you get is gm by r square. This part, gm by r square, is g on the surface of Earth, r. Put value for g, approximately 10, r 6400 kilometer. Solve an answer. Approximate value, please. Yes. 8 into 10 to the power 3 means 8 kilometer per second. So, if a particle moves near surface of Earth, close to the surface of Earth, it needs this much of speed, 8 kilometer per second, near the surface of Earth. If it is bit higher, r will increase. orbital speed will decrease. So if this is Earth, near Earth, suppose it is 8, at some height it is 7, above that it is 6, as you move up, orbital speed keeps on decreasing. Same is true for an electron revolving around the nucleus. When it is close in the first orbit, speed is more. As you move to the higher orbit, the speed decreases. Same model we'll discuss, chapter number 8 plus 2, atom, electron moving around the nucleus. Second part, B part, time period. First part conclusion is with you, orbital speed is equal to g m by r and root. B part, time period. Derive an expression for time period. T is equal to what? Time period T. Time period T is equal to, if a particle completes one circle, distance covered is how much? 2 pi r. The speed with which it moves is orbital speed. So total distance covered 2 pi r divided by speed. Put value for v orbital. Put value for v orbital. 2 pi r. V orbital is equal to what? Gm by r and root. It is equal to what? 2 pi by gm and root. R power, this is 1. When you take it to the numerator, it is 1 plus 1 by 2. What you get is 3 by 2. T is proportional to this. Time period is equal to this. If you square both sides, this is the complete expression. If you square both sides, then what you get is T square is equal to 4 pi square by gm into r cube. This is what? Yes. T square is proportional to r cube is Kepler's third law. T square is proportional to r cube. So this is also proof for Kepler's third law, which we have already covered. C part deals with what? B part is r power 3 by 2. C part deals with what? Yes. Kinetic energy. C part deals with the kinetic energy of the particle. A particle of mass m, it is moving with what speed? V orbital. So kinetic energy of the particle is equal to what? Kinetic energy K is equal to 1 by 2 m v orbital square. Put this value, v orbital value. What you get is v orbital is equal to gm by r. So v orbital square is equal to gm by r. V orbital is gm by r and root, sorry. Square of this is gm by r. So what you get is 1 by 2 m gm by r. So kinetic energy k is equal to gm m by 2 r. D part is potential energy. We have already written the expression for potential energy, U. Potential energy U is equal to what? Minus G M M by R. Yes. In terms of magnitude, this potential energy is how many times? 2 times, because here you are getting 1 by 2. So, for all practical purposes, we write potential energy, just for the sake of understanding, one numerical value, minus 200 kinetic energy 100, or you can write plus 100, total energy is equal to minus 100. We have number of object equations which deal with the ratio. So what is the ratio of potential energy to kinetic energy? Magnitude only, 2:1. Total energy, no doubt I have written the expression, but not the formula here. Total energy is equal to what? Total energy is sum of potential energy plus kinetic energy. Potential energy is what? Minus gmm by r. Kinetic energy, gmm by 2r. When you solve it, what you get is minus gmm by 2r. Total energy is negative. This negative sign will mean what? See, potential energy is minus 200, kinetic is 100, total energy is minus 100 means this is bound. This satellite is bound with the earth. You need to put in 100 unit of energy, you will have to do 100 unit of work to take this particle from this point to infinity. Like in a nucleus, electron moves around the nucleus. You want to remove this electron. You will have to do some work, some effort to remove this electron from this orbit to infinity. You have different names for this. In chemistry, you may term this as ionization potential. Fine. So here, this is bound, the electron, sorry, this satellite is bound with a planet, say in this case Earth. It keeps on revolving around Earth. You will have to do, in this case, in this example, 100 unit of work to move this satellite from this point to infinity. So last part, total energy is minus gmm by 2r. We say the particle is bound. Particle, negative sign means what? Particle is bound with the planet. This is what we mean by this negative sign. 2 minutes with you to complete. Refer to numerical now. Numerical number 23. Numerical is, a satellite revolves around the planet in an orbit just above the surface of the planet, taking capital G 6.67 10 raised to the power minus 11 and the mean density of the planet 5.51 into 10 to the power 3, find period of satellite. You have to find out the time period T. Any formula for time period? This T is equal to 2 pi by gm under root r. R is the distance at which the satellite moves. Here it moves close to surface of the planet. Means what? For the given numerical, the diagram is of this type. Means what? Small r is equal to capital R. That is why it is r 3/2. Square both sides, T square is equal to 4 pi square by gm into r cube. We need to write it in terms of density, not in terms of mass. because density, mean density of the planet is given. Mass is not given. Density of the planet is given. Replace this mass by, yes, density into volume. R cube cancel. What you get is T square is equal to, yes, pi square, this is pi, cancel, 4, 4 cancel, am I right? What you get is 3 pi by g rho, that's it. T square is equal to 3 pi by g rho. 3 into pi, 3.14. T will come out to be under root of this. G is equal to what? Given. Yes? 6.67 into 10 raised to the power minus 11. Density, yes. Density is given as 5.5 into 10 raised to the power 3. 5.5 into 10 raised to the power 3. Solve and answer is in seconds. In SI units, 2 minutes for calculation. Approximately 5,000 seconds. Approximately, exact answer is 5065 seconds. 1 minute more. Confirm this. How many of you are getting close to this? 1 minute more for calculation. Numerical number 25. Question is, the orbit of a geostationary satellite is concentric and a coplanar with the equator of Earth and rotates along the direction of rotation of Earth. Calculate height and speed. Take mass of Earth 5.98 times per 7, 27 grams. You need to change it to kilograms. Radius 6400 kilogram, sorry, kilometers. Given pi square is equal to 9.87. Geostationary. When you say geostationary, yes, you have to find out what? You have to find out, yes, what? Height and speed of a geostationary satellite. When you say geostationary, means what? It has a time period. Angular speed is same as that of Earth. When Earth rotates, the satellite also rotates. Earth takes how much time? 24 hours. Geostationary satellite also takes 24 hours. So, in the given expression, what is known to you is time period. T is given, you have to find out height. First part, again same formula, T square is equal to 4 pi square by g m into r power 3. It is 4 pi square by g m. R, this radius is equal to what? Radius of earth plus height cube. t square. What are the parameters given to you? T is how much? 24 hours. You need to change it to, yes, 60 minutes, then 60 seconds. That means 24 into 30, 600 seconds. Mass is given. How much? 5.98 times per 27 grams, kilograms we can write approximately 6 into 10 raised to power 24 kilograms. Radius, yes, radius is also given 6400 kilometers, 6400 into 10 raised to power 3 meters. All parameters are known. Capital G, 6.67 times per minus 11. Find H. Calculation you can take up at home. When you solve, you will find H comes out to be what? Yes. Check the answer. Comes out to be, yes, 3.6 into 10 to the power 7 means 36,000 kilometers. 36,000 kilometers. 3.6 into 10 raised to the power 7 in meters, it is this value. For objective purpose, geostationary satellite moves at a height 36,000 kilometer above surface of Earth. First part is answered. Second, orbital speed. How you answer the second part? Orbital speed. Yes, v orbital is equal to what? V orbital is equal to g m by r. Capital G, capital M divided by what distance from the center? What distance from the center? R means radius of Earth plus height. Capital G, 6.67 into 10 raised to power minus 11. Mass of Earth given, how much? 6 into 10 to the power 24. Radius of Earth 6400 kilometers. 64 into 10 to the power 3 plus height. How many kilometers? 36,000. 36,000 kilometers means 10 to the power 3. 2 minutes for calculation. Solve. Let's see how many of you come out with correct answer. Anyone with answer, please. Yes, answer is approximately 3.1 kilometer per second. What was the answer when the satellite was moving near the surface of Earth? Orbital speed near the surface of Earth, 8. If you move up, 7, further up, 6. As you keep on moving to more height, h, as h increases, time period, sorry, speed decreases. So for a geostationary satellite, height is how much? 36,000 kilometers. It moves with what speed? Approximately 3 kilometer per second.